Up first this week is Push, which is not based on a comic book movie, but you'd never know it by looking at it. It's about a group of genetically gifted individuals, and they all have little categories. There's pushers who can control your mind, and movers who use telekinesis, and watchers who look into the future. And it takes place in Hong Kong, and the villain is this sort of nebulous entity called Division, and they're trying to round up all of the people with special powers and I guess put them to work doing, you know, some government's bidding. I think the villain is played by Jimin Hansu. It works for the American government, but it's kind of hard to say.
Yeah.
And really it's just them trying to escape Division, and there, supposedly there's some big secret that they can use to bring them down. The good guys can use to bring down the bad guys. And, you know, I mean, it's a decent enough action movie, but not really a whole lot else. I mean, and the main problem with the movie is that, you know, like with the X-Men, you know, it had a group of superhumans, but the audience could relate because really those movies were about, you know, trying to find your place in society and fit in and still be different, that sort of thing. And really there's no way for us as an audience to relate to these people with these crazy powers.
No, I mean, they really have very unique problems. None of their problems are, you know, what you and I go through in a typical day. I think, you know, one of the other main issues in this is the acting was really subpar in this,
even Dakota Fanning.
Yeah, Dakota Fanning. I mean, she is a seer who can see into the future, but she hasn't perfected her powers yet. And Chris Evans is a mover who, you know, hasn't really tried to do anything with his powers. And they're trying to find a girl who's escaped from Division, played by Camilla Bell. And she always, you know, she always looks very confused.
A little sleepy.
And a little sleepy, yeah. And, you know, with the lack of acting ability and really not being able to relate to the characters anyway, it really kind of stacks the deck against this film.
Yeah, and like I said, the action scenes were handled pretty well. There's a guy who can deflect, you know, dozens of bullets all at one time.
Yeah.
It looks like he's got a little shield around himself. But, yeah, I mean, without really a way to get into the characters to relate to their plight, the movie doesn't really become anything more than just a collection of action scenes. So, interesting side note, it was written by a guy named David Borla, and he is the guy that directed Steve Odenkirk's little thumb movies. So maybe that's some sort of an indication of what you're in for. So I would say skip it.
Yeah, I'd agree. And we'll be right back with the next review.